Hey guys, here's the video. Today I'm doing a new set brought to us by Reprolabels. Yay, Reprolabels! I love these things. I really, really do. It's nice having a transformer like Drift and just being able to spice it up a little bit. Like, in most cases, you buy these stickers to make them a little more show accurate. If it's something like the Power Ranger sets, some G1 sets, you know, just the classic stuff. Make them a little more show accurate. Make them look a little better. Drift, I knew he was kind of bland before. I knew he has this detail on the front of the side, which is nice. But I knew he was missing stuff there and just random bits here and there. But I never really noticed how bland he was compared to his comic model. And this is why this set is so cool. I will admit, up front, I was really unsure about this set because of its price. It's a sticker set for a deluxe figure that's, I think, $15. And that kind of, or was it $12? $12 or $15? And that really kind of had me going, well, I don't know if I wanted that badly. But I honestly didn't know how much was included. This is a two-part set. And that is what you get. Like, that's a lot of stuff to include. This, I'll get to, even though it's part one, I'll get to that in a bit. This is part two of two. And this stuff is basically for his car mode, to add some details that his comic version does have. You have some details for the hood, the side skirts of the car mode, the rear bumper, these little license plate tags, which are actually pretty clever. One for Drift, one for Peerless, and then this little spoiler section here, some blue dots for his chest mode, some detailing for the back of his hands. There's a lot. But then you get to this set, this one here. And I guess I'll start from the bottom up. I probably should start from the top to bottom, but whatever. There are some options to customize your Drift to your own liking. Remember his sword, this really kind of a nicely sculpted sword, but really detail-wise, there's not much really going on there. That's what this is kind of fun. You can have three options to customize your swords. That's three, and that looks really kind of creepy from the side. Yeah, this first option is just has this kind of a gunmetal gray that matches the plastic of the sword with this chrome edging all around it. The little kanji symbols do carry over. They are chromed out as well, even though you may not be able to notice because there's just so much light going on. If you don't want the gunmetal gray, you can have fully chromed out swords, again with the symbols on it. If you don't want fully chromed out swords, you can have kind of this blue energon kind of blades. Detailed quite nice. This little gold bit in the middle there, if you can actually see that, I don't know. But just some nice options to have for your swords. Now, whichever option you choose there, you can have corresponding blades with the smaller swords, or have something entirely different. It's really up to you. Again, you got blue and chrome, gunmetal chrome, and I like that. Whichever option you choose for the swords, you can actually customize, like for this little bit here, there's this little section that just kind of stands out there. The blades for the swords go down and then split it to go around it. So you have little options to go with those there. Of course, the gunmetal to go with the gunmetal, chrome, and then yellow to go with the blue. And you have exhaust pipes. These are the actual intersections of the pipes. And I believe these go around the actual pipes. And these are for his kind of front grill section. And then some details for his head, his upper chest, shoulder, windows for the car mode. There's just so much going on here. But a big thanks goes to Formula 93 on YouTube. He's actually the guy who made most of these. And I think he's the guy who did all the Fans Project Insecticons. He's doing the TFC Toys Constructicons. And if I'm wrong, someone's going to shoot me, I know. But he actually did most of these. I think the only ones he did not make the license plate tags, the face stickers, and the blue swords. I think he did everything else. He did most of these. So a big thanks goes to him for these, because these really do look nice. And of course, the best part with these being an upgrade kit, I don't have to take a single sticker off to apply them. Hallelujah. So I'm going to take this guy. Here's the car mode before, just give you an idea what it looks like. And let's go. Okay, and here he is about halfway done if you count the swords. And the vehicle mode really does look a whole lot better. All these little added details, all the stripes, all these pieces there. I had a really nice surprise with this set. In the pictures I had seen online, these stickers look like they really didn't match with these all too well. But they actually have a really nice kind of a shine to match the side panels, but they're also blue to match the real rear window. And it adds a nice little touch to it. But all the stickers that are on the 2 of 2 sheets, that's actually not white paper. It's actually clear. So I really was kind of worried about the white of the sticker matching up with the white of the paint. But since they're clear, there's no issue at all. It looks absolutely perfect. I think I did mess up these a little bit. They look a little bit off. But if you look at it, it does look quite nice. All this front part here, the little spoiler part in the back, the rear section, you see probably the most difference. Just a little A little Peerless license plate tag. The exhaust pipes, there's a black circle that goes inside the pipe, then a chrome that goes on the tip, and then this black part that goes around the edge of it. And it really does add a lot to the vehicle mode. And it just looks a lot nicer in person. So there is a... There's all of that. All that's left now is do the robot mode. And here he is, just to give you an idea just how his robot mode looks real quick. With before the stickers. So I'll get that up there. Of course, here's the sword as it is, that little just dull gray plastic. Nothing too special. The robot mode, the stickers should enhance the little details on his face. These little guys on the side, should be some gold detail there. Those little kind of dots on his chest will be blue now. Some yellow at the top, which I think the United version has those already painted gold, so I may be mistaken. And then, get back up there. Get. There you go. Add some white detailing to his hand, which the comic version does have. And I think last but not least, the blades of these swords. While they already are painted kind of a chromey, not really chrome, but a silver, I will probably switch them out anyway. I'm kind of undecided. This guy, definite sticker. He needs it without a doubt. These, I'm kind of unsure about at the moment, but we'll just have to see when I get there. But that's how he looks before. And here is Drift with his new stickers. Now, I do admit, the details they do add are kind of minor, and you don't really notice unless you're actually looking for them. Can you spot what's different on this guy? Can you? The big ones to me are his chest bits there. Just the added little details there. There are some gold detailing, and it helps if you actually can see it. Those are new. The ones on his cheek are new. And that really does add a different look to him. Just gives a little more detail going on inside. They're not just random gray. Those little gold bits are new. And you can see his hands now have that white detailing. And I think that's really it for his robot mode. Of course, with these other stickers on, they do kind of stand out more. There's not just random, or not random, but not just bland white all over. Those little bits do stand out quite a bit. Now, for his weapons, like I said, I did go with the gunmetal, gray, and chrome. That's how it looks on the sword. I did have one little issue. This side went on with no problem whatsoever. You can see it. But the other side, yeah, let's get you out of the way there. Let's go ahead and focus on you again. You can see the little little characters kind of show through. They are there. I did have an issue with this side, though. The tip did tear as I was pulling it off the sheet. It doesn't look too bad once you get it on there, but... So there's that option. And with these guys, I would say if you do opt to put stickers on them, be a little careful since they are going into the whole sheath thing. You don't want to scrape them off, but of course, there's the gunmetal and the chrome again, one of those. And there's that. I have not had any issue with them rubbing or getting pulled off at all, so that may not be a problem. Maybe enough clearance in there for no issue, but I would still say be careful. But overall, and I'm really impressed with how he does look. It does add a bit to his robot mode. But the car mode, I think, is the main selling point. I have hiccups now, so my voice kind of goes... It's because I have a hiccup that I tried to cut out. But it does look a lot better, and I really do like it. I tried to get in touch with Formula 93 before doing this video. Before doing this part of the video, at least. But I have not got back from yet. But if you look here on the sheets, there are these two little extra stickers there. I'm not sure what those are for. I want to say there may be extra pieces, but I cannot find where they go yet. When I do find out, I'll post an annotation just saying where they go. And it looks like they do include extra bits for his chin and his shoulders, and there are extra blue stickers. So in case you do mess up the ones on his chest, you can redo those. And you have all these extra bits here. So if you by any chance have an extra Drift, which I don't know why you would, you could have multiple options for swords. Having, you know, with one long sword that's this kind, with one long sword that's that kind, whichever you want. You can customize these if you want, just have different types. So these guys, I'm going to put away in case at some point I decide to take these off. I can switch them out, toss the old stickers, and have a new one to put on. It's just nice they're included, and I would say pick it up. I was wrong earlier. It's not $15 for this set. It is actually $12, and I think it's actually really, really worth it. It does add quite a bit to the toy, and let's try to get him in a better pose, because, you know, if you're going to... You're gonna be a samurai, kind of ninja, kind of guy. You gotta be posed nicely, and looks like he's about to fall over. That's the J.T. Mitchell 87 definition of posing a warrior, like they're gonna fall over. Yeah. But I do like it. $12 for this set, I think it certainly is worth it. It does improve the toy quite a bit, especially in the vehicle mode. The robot mode, like I said, the details are nice, what they add, but they do... They are kind of hidden unless you know what to look for. If you look at the vehicle mode before and after, you're going to notice right away the differences. Robot mode, it does take a bit of looking to finally spot them. But I do like them, and I'm glad that I have them on my drift. So there's that. And of course, if you want to buy this set, you can go to reprolabels.com. There's a link in my video description. I would say pick it up if you have drift already. It'll make them look a little flashy. So that's it. I hope you guys have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.